education, this is all about God. It's all about Him. And we, in order for us to say we belong to Him, we got to have a relationship with Him. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Time out for putting on a show. See, that's an outward appearance. And you can impress me and you can try to fool me, but at the end of the day, guess what? I don't have a heaven nor a hell to put you in. You can come in here and love on me, and I'll love on you, but I'm telling you for yourself, you better develop a relationship with God. Amen, amen, amen. Putting on a front. You know, man only sees the outward appearance, but how many of you know God sees the heart of a man, and God knows every thought you have and every thought you don't have in regards to Him. Oh yes, He knows whether your church is a clubhouse or a house of worship. Well, what does it take to have a real relationship with God? First of all, it takes reconciliation. Listen, reconciliation, that's just a big word that simply means He has to break us to make us. When you reconcile something, you make it compatible with something else. Biblically speaking, reconciliation is the process by which God made sinful human mankind compatible with Himself. Paul used the words alienated and enemies to describe our lack of relationship with God. And so what I'm trying to say is that in order to have a relationship with Him, there has to be a reconciliation with Him. You do know that man was created by God, for God, to have a direct relationship with Him. But when sin entered into the scene, sin separated us from God. And so that's why we have to come and confess with our mouth and that we believe in our heart. We don't just automatically become sons and daughters of God. Amen. Amen. Paul says that we are alienated or enemies, and that describes our relationship with Him. In our natural state, we don't fit with God.
Alright.
Oh yes, in other words, we need to understand that the natural man is out of place when it comes to God. Our evil behavior keeps us from fitting in with God. Why? Because God is holy and we are sinful. And the two are like oil and water. They just simply cannot mix. We cannot be walking with God and walking with the world at the same time. And let me put a pin right there. That's what's wrong with the church of today. We try to bring the world standards into the church and try to implement and mix the two. But let me tell you, when we're called out of the world, and the word of God says, touch not the unclean thing, we got to realize that we have to be different. Let me tell you something, that after five that you will wear to the club is not the same dress you wear to communion service. About God.
Yes.
He gave His tithe. Amen.
Yes. Israel was missing in his relationship with God, and God went to great lengths to develop a right relationship with Job.
Right.
You all know the story. Job had to lose everything. He lost his home, his children, his wealth, and his health. You didn't understand why he lost all that, but he didn't lose that wife. Of great loss, Job found greater gain. Job found the key to the right relationship with God. And so that's what I mean when I say God has to break us in order to make us. How many of you know sometimes God has to take you down, and for others, he has to take you way down in order to bring you up to where you're supposed to be. There were three essential things that Job had to learn through his trying, if you will, experience about his relationship with God. First of all, Job had to learn that God is all powerful. That's the first thing we need to understand. In this breaking of us, listen, in order for God breaks us, it usually is because God wants us to know that he's in control. The more we get, the more we think it is us that we have. It's because we can do it. It's all about us. But God sometimes has to remind us that it's not about us at all, but it's all about him. Job had to learn that God is all powerful. After all the trials and tribulations that Job went through, he came to the conclusion about God. Look at verse number 2. Job says, I know that thou can do everything, and that no thought can be withheld from thee. He's talking to God. Now, that's a wake-up call that every one of us must have. In other words, we cannot operate outside of God. We cannot operate apart from God. Many times we get the wrong idea and think because God places people in our lives, those people sometimes replace who God is supposed to be. Sometimes we're blessed with money, and the money can be our God, or the opportunity can be our God. But let me tell you something. All that you had, it came from God, and if God gave it to you, and you lose sight of him, he'll take it back from you and give you a reality check. Job will tell you that God can throw a monkey wrench into your plans whenever he wants to. We can make plans, and we can orchestrate, and we can set times, and we can do, but God has a way of coming in there just stirring up a little something, and then when it's all said and done, what God wants is what happens, and our plans are cast aside. Oh yes, all God has to do is withdraw. Let me tell you, sometimes God has to do it by taking his hands off.
Yes,
that's what he did to Job. He took his hands off of Job. Listen, we love to run around talking about everything that we have accomplished.